So now we are going to take a walk around downtown Erie. Downtown Erie has some amazing local restaurants and local shops that you are going to want to check out. So come with me. One of the fun things about Erie is that we have a hot air balloon launch every year, and it will not be uncommon for you to open up your front door in the morning and see some hot air balloons early in the morning. And so this mural here in downtown pays a little bit of a tribute to our iconic hot air balloons. Let's take a quick tour of Coal Creek Park here in downtown Erie. So now let's drive through some neighborhoods here in Erie. Erie is a pretty new town, and so the majority of the homes are new construction or newer construction. And you will see a lot of new builds and new neighborhoods popping up left and right. So if you are wanting to build a home, Erie is a really great option. So today we will see primarily newer neighborhoods, but I am going to take you through a couple of neighborhoods here that are older and more established, if that is something that you're looking for. So let's go check them out. So one of the things to point out is that because there's tons of new construction here in Erie, we have in Colorado what's called a metro tax. And metro taxes are essentially a way for developers to come in and develop the land and create a neighborhood, the sewer systems and all of that, take on a tax-free debt, and then that gets spread to be paid back by the homeowners through property taxes. I do dive into that metro tax in a video on my channel. So if you are curious about how it's calculated or what it's all about, go check out my channel and see a little bit better of a description there. Right now, we are gonna drive through a neighborhood that does not have a metro tax and it does not have an HOA, which is very rare for Erie. So let's go check out Northridge. All right, so if you were to tell me that you are looking to make the move to Erie, but you are not drawn to the standard new construction look or feel that you see here in our town, then I would probably tell you to look at Erie Village. Erie Village is a very unique neighborhood, and you'll see why when we take a drive around. Look at the style of homes, look at the colors that they have in this neighborhood. It's really, really fun, and if you're just looking for something that's just truly unique and custom, then I would tell you, let's go check out Erie Village. So let's take a drive around. All right, so now we are driving past Soaring Heights, which is a K through 8, and then we are going to drive past the Erie High School. So you can kind of see some of the schools here right in Erie. And then we are gonna go head down a road called Erie Parkway, and we'll see several neighborhoods off of that. It's one of the main, I guess, drags you would call it, here in Erie. All right, so we are now driving along one of the main roads here in Erie called Erie Parkway, and we are currently looking at a neighborhood called the Erie Highlands, and across from that is a very desirable neighborhood called Colliers Hill. And so you can see most of the homes here along this road are, you know, newer homes. These neighborhoods are complete or about to be completed if we're talking about Colliers Hill. But I just wanted to show you this street so you can kind of get a feel of the look of one of the main parts of Erie. All right, so now that we've been an older neighborhood, let's drive through a newer neighborhood here in Erie that is still under construction so you can kind of see the difference. Morgan Hill is the neighborhood that we are gonna drive through right now. And it's a mixture of homes built by Century and Lennar. And so there is still some construction going on. We're kind of nearing the end of the building process here, but one of the things that draws a lot of people to this neighborhood are the amazing views. We are gonna go check those out. And then also the pool. Many of the new construction neighborhoods do have pools or sometimes even a school if they're large enough. And that is a pretty common thing with new construction. A lot of these developers want to come in and make pretty large subdivisions, and they're called master planned communities. So it's a place that you can really hang out in and really enjoy yourself if you're looking for tons of amenities. So we are going to go check out this neighborhood a little bit more. So now we are driving through a neighborhood called Parkland Estates, and this is pretty unique. There is a runway in this neighborhood, and so if you like to fly or you own a plane, this might be a neighborhood to check out. It's on the eastern part of Erie, and as you can see, these neighbors are very close to one another, and so the lots are huge, and there are some homes that are available along the runway with really quick access, and then there are homes that don't butt up against it as much. All right, so we are back out of the car because I want to show you around the amazing new Erie Community Park. The Erie Community Park is huge, and so let's take a look around. There is tons to do here at the park for the entire family. All right, so we're still here in the Erie Community Park, but you can see this big open field right here. Sometimes there's
little soccer games. And the fireworks for Erie are shot off right here. So you typically want to come here really early on the 4th of July. There's some food trucks. It's really, really fun. This is also the typical starting point or ending point for some of the 5K races or stuff that's similar here in Erie. All right, so this is a really fun thing that Erie decided to do. So there is a dedicated tubing hill. So we're gonna go check it out. There's a covered pavilion right here, and then you can see the dedicated little hill here. It's really fun. All right, so now that we looked at a place here at the park for some wintertime fun, we should check out this really awesome pump park that got installed. So if you really are into that, this is really fun for the whole family. And then over here, they have installed some tools if you need to fix up your bike, a pump for your tires. So they thought of it all. There's a fun little pavilion here. And then we are gonna walk through the little jungle gym over here. So they installed some of these climbing structures here. As you can tell, that one's really, really fun. Have a basketball court. And then over in here, you'll see some baseball and softball fields. So we oftentimes see a lot of games going on. The town has like adult softball leagues, which is really fun if you're looking to get involved with the community. All right, so as you can tell, this park is really, really big and there are tons of things to do for the whole family, like I said. So we've seen the sledding hill and the skate park and the jungle gyms for the older kids, but I wanna show you a cute little top park. All right, so earlier we touched a little bit about what draws people to Erie. And as we just walked through the park, you can maybe kind of tell that a lot of people consider it to be a really great place to raise a family. So there is just tons to do around our cute little town. And Erie is a part of some really great school districts. And so a lot of people really seek out Erie just primarily due to the schools and it being a great place for families. So driving factors, just to touch on those a little bit again, is small town charm, great schools, great place to raise a family, and it's just more on the affordable end. And so if you're looking to be a quick drive to Boulder, but you don't want to pay Boulder prices, you maybe want to live in a newer home and you want a little bit of a small town feel, then Erie might be something to consider. All right, so as you can tell, there's some development going on behind me, and that is because I'm standing in front of the new Erie Town Center. And the Erie Town Center will be a mix of residential space, but also some commercial space. So we are set to get a small grocery store, some restaurants, some mixed attached homes and single family homes. And so the Erie Town Center is really, really exciting for some residents because one of the things that people have found lacking here in Erie is that we don't have a ton of commercial space or a central grocery store. And so this development is really exciting for many of the residents here. All right, so I hope you enjoyed our tour of Erie. It has come to an end. And as you can tell, there's so many exciting things happening here in our town, both on the commercial landscapes, but also the residential. Erie really is booming and a lot of people are deciding to call Erie home. If you want to know a little bit more information about this town or the surrounding areas, please feel free to give me a call. I would love to help you out. My phone number and email are on
on the screen. So reach out today. Let's chat a little bit more about what you're looking for. I would love to help you out. Thanks.